Today we're gonna step up your transition game with this.
Yeah, I'm down for the long run now. Red Corvette and my drop top down.
What's up guys? Today I'm gonna teach you guys how to do the spray paint transition that Jesse did in one of his vlogs. For this transition, you're gonna have to make a trip down to Home Depot.
Bottles in a bucket full of ice.
What you're gonna get is a piece of plastic or plexiglass and spray paint. You're gonna want to emulate a green screen, so I would use this fluorescent spray, especially if you're outdoors, because then when you're trying to do the effect, the green that you're using might interfere with like a bush or a tree behind you. This is how I had mine set up. You're gonna put plexiglass in front of your camera so the spray paint doesn't get on your camera, and then you spray right in front of the camera. And yes, that's a mic stand. I don't know how else I was gonna get that plexiglass right in front of it. But that's basically it. You just spray right in front of it. You might have to crop the image down because I didn't spray the whole frame. I messed up, but crop it in. And then you're gonna go to your effects and then you're gonna grab Keter, slam that bad boy right on top of it. And it's already gonna pick up the green, but if it doesn't, pick it up as good as you want it. Click right here and manually select the color. So that means you could do it with any color, but green works the best. And then after you have it keyed out, what you're gonna do is you're going to take another clip and slide it right underneath it. And this is what it should look like.
Yeah, I'm down for the long run now. Red Corvette and my drop top down.
Let me know if there's any other transitions you want me to tackle, and peace out.
Yeah, I'm down for the long run now. Red Corvette and my drop top down. Calling up my digits in my Motorola, and I'm speeding like I robbed someone.